Here we're asked to divide these polynomials using polynomial long division. Here we're missing x to the fifth term, x to the third term, but I don't think it's going to matter in this one. Let's just do the long division and see what happens. What times x squared is equal to x to the sixth? Well, let's try certainly x to the fourth. X to the fourth times x squared is x to the sixth. X to the fourth times negative 3 is minus 3x to the fourth. So you see the like terms lined up. Okay, so when we subtract here, we have x to the sixth minus x to the sixth, which is 0. Now you want that to happen. When you subtract a negative number, that's really addition. So negative 4 plus 3 is 1 positive, I'm sorry, negative 4 plus 3 is negative 1x to the fourth. Okay, and then bring down all the rest of the terms. And do it again. What times x squared is x to the fourth? Well, let's try minus x squared. Negative x squared times x squared is negative x to the fourth. So you want to line that up. You want to match that up perfectly. Negative x squared times negative 3 is plus 3x squared. After which you then subtract. And when you subtract a negative number like that, you're really adding. So negative x to the fourth plus x to the fourth is 0. 2x squared minus 3x squared is negative x squared. Bring down the next term. Okay, and then finally, what times x squared will give me negative x squared? Well, let's try negative 1. Certainly negative 1 times x squared is negative x squared. Negative 1 times negative 3 is plus 3. Those two binomials are exactly the same. So here when I subtract, I should get 0. Negative x squared plus x squared is 0. 3 minus 3 is 0. Okay, so that polynomial went in evenly. And the result is x to the fourth minus x squared minus 1.